Hi, everybody. I'm a robot.
And I'm a stick man.
Down below, you can see a secret red button.
Push the button.
Hello there and welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman.
I'm a game developer.
And today we are going to create a minimap. So let me show you the demo. Here it is. You can see that I can move my character. The tennis balls show up as yellow dots and my character shows up as the red dot. So let's open the example file, which you can find under the description below. Now if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is a link down below where you can download the free version. There's also a link to the pay version, which allows you to create commercial games. You know, games you can sell. So let's go over these assets. Okay, so here is my main character. This is a 8-direction object. These two here are bouncing balls. And under my second layer, I have the map. Okay, so these dots here, they are... Let me zoom in a little bit. Here's the minimap. It's a transparent picture. Now, this is 150 by 113.
My pixel.
Now, how did I come up with that number? Okay, so this is 640 by 480. And this is at 32 pixels, just like the size of my game. Okay. So I'm gonna go to image,
image size,
set this to nearest neighbor, and I'm gonna set this to 150 while constraint proportions is enabled. 50. And now I get the correct proportions for the dot. Okay, that's how I came up with the size of the minimap. So all these small squares are static objects. Let's run this frame, and you notice that nothing happens. Okay, you can move around, but the minimap doesn't work. Let's go to the event editor. The first thing we're going to do is that we are going to prevent the balls from leaving the play area. Make a new condition. First condition, test the position of the ball. If it leaves the play area on the top, down, bottom, or left. We make the ball bounce. I'm gonna copy line one. Paste it. Replace it for the second ball and make the second ball bounce as well. Try it out. Let's prevent our character from leaving the play area. Test the position of the character. Same thing. Player leaves the area, he stops. Try it out. And you can see that now I cannot leave the play area.
But my radar is still not working.
I'm going to create an always under special conditions. And then we're going to set the position of the red dot under the red block. We're going to set the X position
of the red block equals
the X position of the player. You can see that works not too bad. That works fine. Let's divide this by 2.
Divided by 2.
You can see that that's sort of working already. But 2 is a little too much. Okay, so let's set this to 4. Now 4 is sort of working. You can see that I'm out of the map. Not by much. So to compensate for that, we're going to go 2.7. And you can see that that's very accurate. Now we're gonna do the same thing for the Y coordinate. Set Y position divided by 4.27. Right out. See that that works right away. Let's do the same thing for the balls. Now notice that these balls are called ball label 1 and label 2. I'm gonna rename these to red. And then we're gonna do the same thing for the yellow dot. Going to drag the same action under one of the yellow dots. Edit the X and Y.
X first. Rename it from red to label 1.
For the Y. The same thing.
Label 1.
Try it out.
Okay, you can see that now it's tracking the first ball. Now for the second ball, all we have to do is drag the same action under the yellow dot. And we simply change the number from ball 1 to ball 2. Same thing for the Y.
Ball 2.
Try it out. And you can see that now we have a minimap. Alright, so thanks for watching and don't forget to check out my new channel,
The Sparkman Vlog.
Like this video and I will see you in the next episode.